Great start. Is it all just happy feelings about a European plan, even though there really isn't a plan? We're just hoping there's a plan?
That's absolutely right. No concrete details, hopes of a plan really driving up the markets. And it does follow a good week last week where we saw the Australian market gaining 1%. We followed that up with a gain of 1.7% at the start of the week. I guess traders, though, are a little bit nervous because this rise has been very strong, very sharp. And so a question mark on whether it's sustainable, and certainly volumes didn't seem to support that today. We only saw $3.3 billion worth of stock being traded. Still, we did manage to hit the highest level that we've seen since the 2nd of September. If we have a look across the market, every single sector traded higher today, but the best by far was the material space. We did see commodities doing well, with copper prices up by 3.1% on Friday, and a lot of news coming out of that mining sector. We saw Fortescue with its first quarter numbers. That stock was up by 4.5%. Rio Tinto saying that it's looking at restructuring its aluminium business. That stock up by 2.4%, and BHP Billiton also doing well. Of course, we did see a positive lead on Friday from the US market. Retail sales in the US surprising on the upside. Here in Australia, we did get lending finance numbers up 2.2% in August, although motor sales were down by 1.5%. in the month of September. Also, some highlights today. Mesoblast trading at an all-time high. We saw the stock up by 5.5% today. The stock's been up 73% in the year to date so far. And if I can bring a chart of its five-year chart up, this is MSB Mesoblast. You can see what a ride it's been, from trading under $1 during the global financial crisis to now trading just shy of that $10 mark by about 2 cents. On the flip side, in the retail sector, we did hear that Super Retail will be buying Rebel, but that didn't seem to help the retailers. We saw Pacific Brands trading down 3.5%. We also saw JB Hi-Fi down by about 2.6%, but altogether a pretty good start for the market.
Tinto, interesting news, looking to shed some of their aluminium businesses. They're looking to streamline. The market seemed to like it. I mean, a good move. Rio shares closing up 2.42% today.
I think Rio Tinto share price just reflecting the strong commodity-based moves that we saw over the weekend. In fact, if you have a look at that material space, all across the board, they're doing well. If we have a look at its aluminium business, it's one out of five different products groups that Rio Tinto has. And if we have a look at this area, it includes bauxite, aluminium, as well as alumina. And if we have a look at prices, well, the aluminium prices in the last quarter were down by 20%. When you're looking at producing aluminium, you pretty much become an electricity trader, and that's because up to 40% of the costs of producing aluminium are in electricity. And if we have a look at this space, not only have we seen aluminium prices coming down, but electricity costs have been going up over the last year. So it is a difficult area, not surprising to see a bit of restructure. If we have a look at the commentary coming through from Rio Tinto, though, they're saying that they're going to focus in on their tier one assets and also trying to increase the profitability of their product groups. So altogether, I guess it's good news. They are looking to eventually divest 13 different assets, Australia, New Zealand, Europe, as well as in the US. And they're going to put this in a separate venture called Pacific Aluminium until they decide when they're going to sell these assets. But altogether, Rio Tinto's share price really just tracking those higher commodity prices that we saw over the weekend, up by 2.4%.